This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Get a pedicure, get your hair today. See, you're telling me I'm pretty, but it's obvious. I don't need a man to tell me where the party is. You a fly girl, get your nails done. Get a pedicure, get your hair today. See, you're telling me I'm pretty, but it's obvious. I don't need a man to tell me where the party is.
Checklist, tick it off, what you got? Pricey, so you better have a lot. A timepiece, send it on TikTok if you can't afford.
Good morning this morning and welcome back to Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, your station for fresh news, smart talk all day. It is Wednesday, the 6th of March, 2024, and you are on the clock with Erin Greene. The song we opened the show with is Fly Girl by Flo featuring Missy Elliott, and it is a part of the official IWD 2024 mix by DJ Ampero. IWD means International Women's Day, and DJ Ampero creates a playlist every year for International Women's Day, positive music about women, by women, for women and men and family and community and celebration. Sometimes even and morning, O-U-R-N-I-N-G. And joining me in studio this morning are Alicia Wallace, founder and director of Equality Bahamas, and Sonia Farmer, poet, writer, publisher, revolutionary, producer of the grand idea, the Antithology. I'm waiting to see it. Owner and operator of Pontiana Paper Press. Again, Ms. Sonia Farmer and Alicia Wallace. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
Now, before we get the show started, I have to say happy birthday to 175 people. Mm-hmm. First of all, let's start by saying happy birthday to one Mrs. Leela Greene.
Happy birthday, Miss Greene.
I'm going to need all of y'all to say happy birthday to Miss Greene, because in truth, it is her voice that you hear on the radio every day.
That's true.
I teef it. It was such a good voice. I said, I'm going to use that one. And so say happy birthday to her. When you're in traffic and you look and you see somebody scowling at them, and then they smile, it's the smile. It's her face that I'm wearing. Just watch the smile. It's a good one. I love it. So if you all know Mrs. Leela Greene, tell her happy birthday. If you see her on the road, honk your horn, raise a glass, not of alcohol. You better be drinking coconut water today. Mm-hmm. Drink some coconut water. Now, there's a whole bunch of other people on my list. Secondly, I have to say happy birthday to Verna St. Rose Greaves. Now, my Caribbean sisters, let's get together and give Auntie a big hug as she, I'm sure she roasting some breadfruit and sipping some brandy right now, because it's never too early for birthday celebrations. Also, we have to say happy birthday to David Thurston, to Emerson Stanton Roll, to Darren Stubbs, to Janine Walker, to Bernique Popel, to Josette Christie, to Christoph S. Carey, my other cousin from the Methodist Church and the DeVoe and Carey families, Randolph Bolin, J. Lee Thompson, and once again, I have to say happy belated birthday to my brother-in-law, Serge Lambert. Happy belated birthday to LaShant A. Wright. Happy belated birthday to Anari Neely and Dr. Derek F. Pinder. Okay, now, ladies, y'all thought I forgot y'all, eh?
No.
Today,
I was just like, that's a lot of Pisces.
Today is the 10th anniversary of Equality Bahamas, the organization that you represent, Alicia Wallace.
Double digits.
10 years in the business of advocacy, advocating for women and girls, boys and men, advocating for gender policies, advocating for the eradication of violence generally, and specifically violence against women and girls. Good morning, ladies. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Great to be here.
Thanks for having us.
Okay, so today we're going to be talking about International Women's Day, and we're going to be talking about the International Women's Day March and Expo. But I want to start the show with a small, like, disclaimer or explainer, right? Because often when we talk about women's rights, women's rights advocacy, gender advocacy, whenever there's a focus on a spotlight on women, we tend to hear, what about the men? You're ignoring the men. And now there's this trend that's arisen where the act of focusing on women is declared discrimination against men. Right? Like, no, you can't, at no point can you talk about women without talking about men. And So I want to share this brief explainer to preface our conversation. So we started imperialism. Imperialism is a policy of extending a country's power and influence through colonization, use of military force, or other means. Motives for imperialism include economic, cultural, political, moral, and exploratory control. That's like, hey, I think they have gems and gold over there, and we should have the right
or to oil.
Or
I just wanted to bring it into the present day.
Absolutely.
Imperialism persists.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I don't want people also to forget that, because we think that gems and gold and like that, you're talking about the 1800s, right? It's 2024. Mm-mm. But in some African states now, there's great conflict around the discovery of minerals and other things in the ground. Mm-hmm. But most importantly, oil. All across the world right now, there are proxy wars being fought for the love of oil. Or the love of money generated by the sale of oil. Okay, so racism and sexism now are two of the means of extending said power. They're two tools that are used to reinforce the imperialist agenda by keeping us divided and distracted. Mm-hmm. Now, patriarchy is a system of society or government in which men hold the power and women are largely excluded from it. At the same time, patriarchy is a structural force that influences power relations, whether they are abusive or not. And patriarchal beliefs of male heterosexual dominance and the devaluation of girls and women lie at the root of gender-based violence. And I want to stick on that phrase, patriarchal beliefs, right? Now, it's important to note that both men and women can and do perpetuate patriarchal beliefs, practices, and systems. Men can and are also victims of patriarchal beliefs, practices, and systems. Mm-hmm. Both men and women can use patriarchal systems to discriminate against or perpetuate violence against men as well as women. Men and women can be victims of gender-based violence, but predominantly women are the victims of gender-based violence. It's also important to remember that people can be victims of oppression, violence, discrimination, and prejudice, and perpetuate oppression, violence, discrimination, and prejudice at the same time. For a little snapshot example, think of a family structure where the father is the head of the household, the mother works, but is obviously subservient to him. At the end of each pay period, the husband, the father in the household, demands the mother's paycheck. She gives it to him in fear of reprisal, violence, psychological violence, physical violence. What he is doing is financial violence, right? She worked for that money. It's her decision how to spend that money, but he takes it. She is a victim. That mother then turns around and looks at her mother, Grammy, or grand aunt, that's forced to live in the house because she's displaced by a hurricane on the family island where she lives. The mother then turns to that elderly relative and says, well, I ain't got no money, so you guys start contributing. And the mother then takes the money that the grandmother or grand aunt gets through pension, social support, charity from church, friends, and family. She then turns around and takes that money. So that mother can be a victim of a form of violence and perpetuate violence at the same time. That mother may not act out only in that way. That mother may project her frustration as violence onto her children. They may not know why mother is hard on them all the time, why she never talks but to cuss. Because she is processing her own victimness in a negative or dangerous way. So I just wanted to put these things out on the table, because often when we have a conversation that's focused on women's rights or gender-based violence, the first question to come up is, well, what about the men? And so even though we are talking from the perspective of the female victim, who is the predominant victim in this situation, this conversation does not exclude men. And if there is a part of the conversation where you think men are excluded, feel free to insert your experience or your observation. You could even call it an intervention. But I want you to know that we are welcome to that engagement, because we don't see that as contrary to what we're talking about. It's not a war or a battle between men and women, but to understand how violence operates, we have to frame it properly. And that is to understand, one of those things is to understand that women are predominantly the victims of sexism, predominantly the victims of gender-based violence, predominantly the victims of patriarchy. And I tend to explain patriarchy like this. Patriarchy is the dog that has turned to bite his owner's hand. Men are also suffering oppression under patriarchal systems. Men's identities are also being severely limited under patriarchal systems. An example, when the man says, "But can I get go home, man? My wife just had the baby. I stop off after work, but I gotta go home and I gotta pick up my shift." "But what you talking about, man? Don't take care of baby." The man said, "What you mean? I gotta have some skin-to-skin contact. My baby gets to know me. Not just the mother, but to know me as well." And the men give him a hard time. Or his boss says, "No, you can't have an extra week off. You didn't born the baby." Because the boss refuses to acknowledge the vital and integral role that fathers play in a newborn's life, in a post-antenatal, in an antenatal woman's processing, right? Mm-hmm. Men have to be there. They help. It's not just that they help make the baby, right? That's what we say when we blame them. Well, they help them make the baby. But they help to make the baby. It's their baby as well. And these are formative experiences that men deserve to have with their babies, mm-hmm. right? Even some men say, "I won't be in the birthing room." And the woman may say, "Listen, I am not ready for our relationship to extend to that point yet. I don't know how I gonna feel with you watching me push this baby out." And then he has to say, "Well, I want to respect you. I want you to be comfortable as possible. I can sit out with father-in-law or whatever." Mm-hmm. Right? Men have to weigh that. That's a balance. So let's give them as much time as they could have with their brand new babies. Anyway, for me, it's a joy to talk about it, right? Because I'm hearing more and more men express that. "No, I want time off. No, I want to be there." Anyway, just a brief explainer about how patriarchy works, how gender-based violence works, mm-hmm. how sexism works. Now, ladies, this Friday, the 8th, is International Women's Day. It's that time again.
Can't believe it.
Can you tell the audience why International Women's Day is important?
International Women's Day is one day of the year that we focus on women, the accomplishments that we've made in the political, social, cultural, economic spheres, as well as draw attention to some of the issues that women continue to face, you know, decades and decades, centuries and centuries after some of these issues started through oppressive systems like the ones that you described mm-hmm. earlier. And, you know, we use this as an opportunity to celebrate women, but also to push for progress when it comes to women's rights and gender justice.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Awesome. And so this year, the Center of Activity for Equality Bahamas is going to be the International Women's Day March and Expo on Saturday. Give us the details for the event.
We are really excited to be hosting this event again. We've been doing it since 2017, every year. Have a lot of fun planning it, doing all the lead up, but especially on the day itself. So it is a day that is feminist, fun, family friendly, and completely free. And you might have some questions about how it's free when we tell you everything that's going on and all the resources and services that are available. Well, we start with a march. That's when we demand our rights. Mm-hmm. So we talk about the need for gender equal nationality laws. We talk about the need to criminalize marital rape. Lots of other issues come up, like comprehensive sexuality education, having no taxation on menstrual hygiene products. People come and bring their issues on their placards, and we take to the streets. So we march from the Eastern Parade, which is between East Bay Street and Dowswell Street, close to the Sydney Poitiers Bridge. And we march from there to the Dundas on Mackey Street. So it's a good little walk. It's not too much. It's pretty nice. It's about 30 minutes, maybe, at the pace that we go. And we arrive at the Dundas, where the expo opens immediately with Zumba. So after a little walk, we give our bodies a little shake.
Good stuff.
And we have
Zumba with Deidre?
With Miss Deidre. Yeah,
right.
We had her last year. People loved it. So why not go for round two?
Now, what is Zumba?
Zumba is this thing.
It's a dance. It's a dance-based exercise. So you have fun.
Dancercise.
It doesn't feel like exercise because you're having fun. And I think it's all about coordination and everything too, balance. Yeah.
Cool. Would you call it dancercise?
Dancercise.
You think this is the 90s?
Yes.
You think this is the early 90s?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm going to get my leg warmers. I ready for that. Okay. And next on the event, in fact, so the expo is 9 till 3:30?
10 to 3.
10 to 3.
So we start the march at 9.
Right.
And we arrive at the Dundas. We have a little shake, we do Zumba, and then the expo officially opens at 10.
Okay.
So that's when the exhibitors are ready to receive all of the participants. So we'll have the Bahamas Crisis Center, Hands for Hunger, Bahamas National Trust, Bahamas Sexual Health and Rights Organization, which is also known as BASHRA. Mm-hmm. We'll also have Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Real Estate, who will be there to talk about home ownership.
Okay.
So the steps towards getting your own home and getting pre-qualified and all that good stuff.
And you're going to have BANROP there, the Bahamas Network of Rural Women Producers?
Not only will BANROP be there with a table, we also have Martha Hannah Smith, who literally wrote the book on Bahamian bush medicine. And she will be there all day to talk to people about bush medicine, to introduce us to the plants, help us to identify the different leaves and learn about which one of these bush good for what.
That was really popular last year.
Super popular.
Yeah.
It's so popular, it inspired a part of my talk, which is at 11 a.m., Sustainable Gardening with Erin. And there's going to be a little extra part at the end. It's called From Field to Fancy. Three tips from the Field to Fancy handbook.
All right.
Yeah.
I like that. Wait, will you have actual handbooks? We'll talk.
That's going too far.
Yeah.
That's for next year.
We'll
next
have to
year.
Talk about that. We'll have to talk about that. You and me.
We can pull three tips out of the Field to Fancy handbook.
Like
and
that.
One of them is a bush-inspired recipe.
Cool.
Yeah.
And then there's also activities all day.
Yes.
So there's talks. There's Helen Clonaris is leading a healing writing.
Writing for healing.
Mm-hmm.
And then also energy healing with Helen.
That's right.
And it's going to be, so we start at 11. The first session is at 11.
Her writing session is at 11. And then she moves into her healer mode.
Right, at 1 p.m.
Where she'll be doing the energy healing.
And if you miss the 1 p.m. session, she's also...
Well, it's drop-in from 1 to 3. So you just pop in for a little 10, 15-minute treatment. So it'll be running all day.
Awesome. Awesome.
Well, for those 2 hours.
Meditation with Margot.
Yes.
Yoga with Antonio.
Yes.
Taking Care of Me with Erica.
Really looking forward to that.
That's
one.
That's Erica Robinson,
yes,
right?
Yes. She is a life coach. And one of the areas that we've been focusing a lot on is the unpaid labor that women and girls undertake and the way that we can sort of push ourselves to the side in service of family, friends, community, and forget about ourselves. So we're really good at taking care
Mm-hmm.
But this session is about how do we take care of ourselves? How do we learn to recenter ourselves?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Erica Robinson was the proprietor of the Glass Window.
Glass Kitchen.
Oh, my God.
Every day I miss it. Banana pancake.
Roasted potatoes and veggie potatoes. Burgers and eggplant sandwiches. But Erica's presence in that community, right? Tremendous. Constantly giving. And even as an employee of hers, right? Just constantly giving. And so it's great to see that she's still feeding people. Went from feeding the belly to feeding the spirit, feeding the soul. Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Walk with Confidence with Chantel. Is that about body posture? And
yes. So remember Chantel O'Brien was Miss Bahamas in 2021. She was the one to make history, making it to the top 10 in Miss Universe.
Mm-hmm.
So she is going to give us a little tutorial on getting our walk on. Which
now,
I
listen,
think should be pretty exciting. Don't come in heels, though. I don't think that's the best way to practice.
And not on those grounds. They're a little uneven.
You just don't want me to shine. Y'all don't know what y'all in for once I get my catwalk together.
I am desperate for you to be in the final walk-off because I think there's going to be a prize.
I for that.
This is exciting.
I for that. But more importantly, I think women don't really think about posture and how it affects their health, right? And one particular thing for women to remember, especially those who wear heels, high heels all the time, that wearing heels offset your center of gravity. You can wear them, but it requires a great posture, extreme core strength, and core control. Otherwise, you can cause or create an environment for detrimental health conditions or risks, right? Because you're shifting your center of gravity. Mm-hmm. So for women who like to wear heels or women whose jobs require them to wear heels, women with front-facing jobs, customer-facing jobs, this may be a session for you to make sure that you're doing it the right way and to prevent back injury and unnecessary back pain. STEM with Abrielle Meredith and Tony. What is that? Because is that another bush? I want it to be a bush medicine. STEM, picking leaves. That's what we're doing?
It could be a particular kind of medicine. These are three women in STEM, in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
Okay.
They are all incredible. And I'm not even going to spoil it with what all they do. One of them is certified in like HVAC and air conditioning and refrigeration based in Grand Bahama. And she's come to Nassau to be with us to have this conversation.
Okay.
That's Abrielle Thompson. We also have Meredith Johnson Evans, who is also one of the founders of Women's Haven.
Okay.
Which was making the menstrual hygiene products.
Okay.
Which I know you've talked about, Erin.
Yes, so
I
excited.
That might be exciting for you.
Yes.
And we have Tony Cartwright Seymour from BPO.
Okay.
So it's going to be a great conversation, I think. Just them talking with each other for us, right? Mm-hmm. About how they got into the field, what it was like when they decided that they wanted to get into that area, how they've been received or not received,
mm-hmm.
the challenges and the rewards of being in the field. So this is great for women, for girls, for students to come and hear about the realities of being in STEM.
Absolutely. I think I may have encountered one HVAC assistant. Mm. That's fantastic. Because we always get excited when we see women doing things that they don't traditionally do. But air conditioning is big business in the Bahamas.
Mm-hmm.
That's a space to get into, ladies. You're trying to figure out what to do, we need plenty HVAC technician. Okay, now, Taking Care of Me, Yoga with Antonio, Finding Calm in Chaos with Jessica.
Jessica Russell, that is a Grand Bahama-based therapist.
Okay.
She's also on the board of Equality Bahamas, and she will be coming in from Grand Bahama as well to run this session about dealing with anxiety, dealing with difficult times, and how we can, even within difficult environments, come back to ourselves and learn some grounding techniques, which I think all of us can use.
Yeah, I can 10 out of 10 recommend her. She got me through last year, which was a difficult year for me. She's an incredible therapist, so I think her session will be really, really helpful for a lot of folks.
That's awesome. And now to perhaps my favorite session on this list, For the Love of Food with Ashley.
Yes, yes. We had Ashley with us in January for Women's Wednesdays.
Okay.
She is a health coach, and she talked to us about food and our eating habits and the way that we kind of demonize food, make food the enemy. Mm-hmm. And also our body.
No, food's not the enemy. It's my mouth. My mouth is the enemy. And food is okay. It tastes great.
You know, some people out here struggling because they think they can't eat certain things.
Yeah.
Limit themselves a lot. Don't want to have any fat. So she talks about, you know, the way that we need fat. Mm-hmm. The way that the amount of fat that we need, the kind of fat that we need depends on the kind of lifestyle that we live. So she's going to talk to us about getting the love back in our food and our meals.
So
taking
you mean
care of ourselves.
People don't know why we have winter pears? We have winter pears so you could get good fat in the winter.
Let them know.
Because your body be craving that fat because it get cold. I mean, we're supposed to be in Africa, right? But here we are. It gets cold.
This is where we find ourselves.
Yes. Winter pears are to help your body, I won't say beef up, pun intended, on good fats. Now, why you didn't tell me Nom Nom Peter is going to be providing the menu for the whole day?
We had Nom Nom Peter last year, and we thought, you know what? That went pretty well. Let's ask them if they're willing to come again and also willing to provide vegan options, because that was a big ask, and that's something that they do anyway. They have put together a menu just for us, and we're really happy about it because everything on the menu is $10 or less. So making it as accessible as possible.
And is Nom Nom Peter owned and operated by young women?
Yes, it is.
Call their name, man.
That's Samaya Cargill and I think some siblings. It's all women, Bahamian women, who also love food.
My kind of people.
And also love making sure that we have dips and sauces and things to go with our food. You know, we like that.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
The food a little wetter.
Next year, I'm going to be there with my own business. It's going to be called Greene's Gravy Grotto because anything swimming in gravy is fish. Rasta, don't worry about it. Don't mind what I say. But I can be there with my... Okay.
Did you see that we also have an art space this year? That's the first time for that. We have a dedicated art space. 6260 Art Gallery is curating an exhibition for us with four women artists. So that's going to be pretty cool.
It's operated by June Colley. Her gallery is downtown.
AKA June.
That's right.
What? Good morning. Good morning, June.
Yeah.
This is, okay. But that's going to be great. But will it be greater than the children's space by Sustainable Me? Will you have a bouncing castle? Are adults allowed on the bouncing castle?
I don't know about a bouncing castle, but I did hear that the children them are going to be making seed paper and decorating the paper. And I think that there's another secret activity that we haven't been
told about. When you say by the children, you mean anybody who's in that activity?
They have said that they will accommodate a few adults here and there. They're going to be selective about it, so I think you might have to nice them up a little bit.
Get me on a list. Sustainable Me. I don't like calling children's names on the radio without their parents' permission, but I know all them children. I in. I could be good. Okay.
Right.
Letterpress printing with Pontiana Paper Press.
That's right. We're really excited to be there again. Last year, we had a tent that was a zine-making activity all day. So we made feminist zines.
What's a zine?
A zine is a small, sort of subversive publication, usually handmade. So we utilized whatever we had. So we had some hand stamps, we had some magazines, people did collage, people wrote poetry. There were a few prompts, from what I recall. And I showed people a few different folded structures that they could use. So you take a single sheet of paper and you make a couple folds and a couple cuts, boom, you have a book, 8-page book. So we did that last year. That was really fun. So this year, especially if all goes well, as I'm still pulling it together, we're going to be doing a mobile letterpress printing call and response collaborative art project. And the project is called What More Y'all Want. And it is a collaboration with Equality Bahamas. And it was one of the submissions for our call for the contemporary anti-thology. So this was an idea put forth by Equality Bahamas to make some sort of community call and response project under this theme, What More Y'all Want. Alicia, do you want to explain how What More Y'all Want, how that came about?
Sure. It hasn't happened yet unless there's a text message I haven't seen. But generally, when we go on radio shows, on, you know, whatever spaces we enter to talk about women's rights, at some point, somebody, usually a man, calls in or raises their hand and says, women already have all the rights. Y'all the one graduating from school. And when I go into bank, all I see is women. What more y'all want?
I could top that. One year, during National Women's Week, at the National Women's Week church service, the lead speaker, the keynote speaker at the church service, entitled his sermon, "What More Do Women Want? What More Do Y'all Want?" That was a sermon that he decided to deliver at the church service for National Women's Week.
Wild, wild, yeah. Well,
not even surprised.
Well, we decided to take that and run with it.
Yes.
I love this idea that Alicia put forward with Equality Bahamas. I think it's great. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a tent and we're going to be giving the prompt, "What more y'all want?" Like, earnestly. Okay, since you're asking, what more do you want? Mm-hmm. Because the answers probably very useful to hear, because honestly, it's just a provocation. It's meant to shut conversation down. It's meant to send people into a rabbit hole. And so instead, we're just asking the public, okay, what more y'all want then? So we want to hear what people have to say, and they're going to be able to take some wooden movable type, mm-hmm. which I use in letterpress printing at Poinciana Paper Press. And they're going to set their answer in this type. We're going to ink it up and we're going to print it on a... it's a mobile wooden provisional press.
All right.
In the space, in the tent. So anyone can come, set a reply, and then those pieces are going to go up in our gallery, which is located in our space at 12 Parkgate Road. Mm-hmm. And we're going to open an exhibition called "What More Y'all Want," mm-hmm. same name, on March 16th. And again, at the exhibition, people will have a chance to come and set... work with the letterpress, provisional press, set some type and put a response. And it will be throughout the day an organic exhibition where pieces will be constantly added to the wall based on the answers. And we will build a website and create a little zine, a little publication, free downloadable publication with all of the answers. All the things we want. Since you're asking.
And thank you for asking. What I would like is for the Tourism Development Fund to subsidize the removal of VAT and duty on feminine hygiene products, and maybe just subsidize them entirely so that all women and all girls under the age of 16, then you have to leave school. All women under the age of minimum 16. Have access to feminine hygiene products free of charge.
Great. See, that's one right there. You would just come. Subsidized all menstrual products. We will set that, print it, boom.
Because apparently there's nothing I could do about it. Right? And, there's just nothing I could do about
it. Quick plug. They're not able to be with us this year, but we usually have the Dignified Girl Project.
The Dignified Girl Project.
And they collect pads, tampons, underwear for girls and women. And they actually now have embarked on this project where they are putting... sort of vending machines in schools with pads free. Mm-hmm. So you don't need to put your dollar in there or your little quarters. The girls in schools can access these. I don't remember how many exactly they have in schools, but they're doing great work. You should definitely look up the Dignified Girl Projects. Mm-hmm. For those
a machine that takes tokens, so you could always just give a token to get it. You don't actually need cash. But if you have cash, you could pay for the cash and get a token. I got two texts here. I think it's a great time to put them in the show. The first text says, "Hey, Erin, those women," in reference to a dynamic where a delivering mother may not want the husband in the room. It says, "Hey, Erin, those women had no problem with the man putting the baby in them, but they shame for the man to watch them push the baby out." Dear texter, this is an excellent text. Let's talk about it just for a second. So basically... watching a woman deliver a baby is going to be the most powerful experience you ever have. But it changes the nature of the relationship between husband and wife, man and woman. When a man sees the awesome capacity of that body part, what is actually intended for? Like, why the reason why it is so awesome is because of this function. Right? When you see that, for many men, it's difficult to return to the prior state of intimacy, right? Like, sometimes men have difficulty with that image and then returning to sexual intimacy with their partner. Mm-hmm. And not because it's a horrible thing to watch, but because it's a magnificent thing to watch. And once you realize the awesome power of, and call it that process, then you may think that just having sex is trivial. Mm-hmm.
Also, it's an issue of consent, isn't it? I mean, consent changes in every situation between every power dynamic and every moment. So, you know, there may be consent for intercourse, but not consent for a person to come and watch this.
It's a fascinating discussion, right? And I think it's subjective, the reasons why men want to, the reasons why men do it once and then maybe not want to do it again.
Right.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's the music. We're going to go to a break. When we come back from the break, we're going to continue this conversation. Texter says, because we know we can't please them. Listen, Texter.
You said it.
We'll be right back on The Clock with Erin Greene.
Every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. You can buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Now is the time to reach your Grand Bahama market with affordable packages, including print and digital. Call GB News sales representative Kavandre at 822-6717 or message him on WhatsApp for ad rates. Classified ads are now available every Tuesday as well. Keep up with everything Grand Bahamian every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Morning and welcome back to On the Clock with Erin Greene. Okay, that conversation we were just having, guys, it's an important conversation.
Mm-hmm.
We have to create a space to have it and try and bring men and women in. There's no judgment. There's no negative. We're not casting blame, no judgment. We just wanted to explore some of the reasons why men want to be in, don't want to be in, why women don't want their partners to be in, why they want them to be in. And it's really subjective. The most important thing, though, is that if you're a part of that community, that family, that you support the two primary people in their decisions, right? Mm-hmm. That's the most important part. And some men say, look, I'm so glad that I witnessed it because I have so much respect for this woman now. Some men say, okay, I understand now why I need to wait this length of time before engaging or attempting to engage in sexual intimacy again with my newly birthing partner, right? Mm-hmm. It's actually quite an interesting conversation. The text says, and what more do you want, but we need male, female, and children to form a community. Right, see, Texter, the conversation we're having does not exclude men. It doesn't exclude children.
Anyone can come, make a poster, and talk about what more we want towards, more feminist, equitable Bahamas.
Now, come here. Make poster how?
Oh, yes, this is at the Expo, the International Women's Day
right,
March and Expo that Equality Bahamas is facilitating on Saturday.
At the Dundas. On Mackey Street.
On Mackey Street, free. So from 11 o'clock, we will be operating this tent in order to facilitate collaborators to come by and make a poster for this exhibition. So we'll have a tent there from 11 to about 3. And people will have a chance to try out letterpress, ink up some type. It's really fun.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
It's a great craft. Yeah.
Yeah.
And set a response to what more y'all want.
Listen, a mobile printer. Mobile printer.
Wild. Did not know it existed.
Listen, I love it.
Hoping I can pull it off.
I love it. Okay.
You might see a zine tent again, in which case that is also still
fun. No, it's
going to
work.
Yeah, man. And even if, even if the press doesn't work, Are we able to pick up like the wooden block letter and then dip it in ink and then press it?
You arrange it with the letters facing up. So essentially you arrange it backwards. I'll be on hand to help. And also my colleague Candida, who is one of our press family, will be there to help your mind wrap around setting something backwards. Then you add ink on top, put the paper on top and print it that way. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. As opposed to how we are making our signs this year, which is silkscreen printing.
Now, that's taking place tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Sign making for the march. So if you want to come on the march, I can't make any signs at home. My children done teeth all my markers. Oh, I don't want them to know I have an art pantry. You can come out to Pontiana Paper Press this evening.
Yes.
What time?
From 3 o'clock through to 7 o'clock, we will be having an open sign making and printing session. And we're located at number 12 Parkgate Road.
All right.
So you can just come in. We will be printing bandanas. We will be printing T-shirts. And look, we have a bandana for you, Erin.
Present.
What?
Do you like it?
I love it.
Ooh. Tell people how cool it is so that they can come print one. Because if you come print one as a volunteer, you do get
one. You hand printed this?
Yes. Also, if you march with us, you get it. So this is designed by Margot Bethel, who is also basically our maker in residence at the press.
Yep. Lovely.
She made this two-color design. It's white and a blue violet on a red bandana. And it features the butterfly pea flower, which Equality Bahamas is utilizing.
Look how you're going right into my field to fancy handbook just like
okay.
that.
Okay, so tell us more about it,
tell
Alicia.
Tell us about the flower since you,
you
know everything.
The butterfly pea flower is a wild flower. It grows wild in New Providence. It likes sort of a little damp, marshy roots. It's blue. It's a vibrant
blue. So beautiful.
Blue. It's an edible flower, so you may have eaten it or seen it on a fancy salad going past you in a fancy restaurant. And it's magical. We call our lemonade and our iced tea that we make with it Chikchani lemonade and Chikchani iced tea because of this secret. It will give you a naturally blue drink.
Hmm.
So your kids like Kool-Aid. They like colors. So what color, you know, what type of Kool-Aid you want? Blue.
Yeah. It's used as a dye.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason that we chose the flower is that we found, while it does like sort of the marshy area, it likes the sort of sandy soil, it can grow in pretty bad soil.
Yes.
And it actually enriches the soil where it grows.
Mm-hmm.
And we thought, oh, like women.
Yeah.
Right? Yes. Like we're growing and trying to survive in very bad environments, really rough environments, and somehow we end up making the environment better.
And if you knew the scientific name of the plant, you'll understand why the analogy is so apt.
Yes,
but we're not going to call...
Look it up.
Yeah, look it up. I'm not going to call it on air. Just call it Chikchani flower when you
love that.
See it. This is awesome.
So we've printed the symbol also of the flower also on the posters.
Okay.
So we've put that down through silkscreen printing, but we need people to come and add some slogans. What do we want to see in the march? What do we stand for? What do we want to powerfully project? What do we want to demand for, you know, women and also by extension? Because when we make things good for women, we make things good for the whole community.
Absolutely.
Right. This is why, like, you know, when one person isn't free, none of us is free.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you want to come put on the poster? Please come put the poster. We have some stencils. You don't have to use your handwriting. Use some stencils.
Spray paint. Markers.
Whatever. Yeah.
All right. I think we may have a call coming in. We'll get to them in a second. Another text. It says, the guy said, listen, I don't want to go inside that room because my wife is crazy. Said some women is cuss when they in the... Listen, you're going to see a side of your wife, your partner, your wife, your baby's mother, right? Your significant other that you perhaps may have never seen before. Because, like the old folks say, she is between two worlds. She got one foot in the realm of spirit and one foot here with us on the planet. Mm-hmm. She gonna say some things to you. She gonna ask you who you is. You gonna look at her like, Miss, you would be the admired. But this is a part of the bonding of relationship, right? And this is a part of the bonding of having a child. Producer, the caller was okay? Okay, caller, you'll be all right. It's a great conversation. The playlist, DJ Ampero.
Get it, tiny.cc/IWD242mix.
IWD242mix.
Yes, tiny.cc/IWD242mix. That will take you to Mixcloud. And if you are a Spotify person, tiny.cc/IWD242tunes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And again, the person who made it is DJ Ampero.
So DJ also, Ampero.
You can also find him, yeah, on Mixcloud and Spotify.
You can find him at the expo because he's going to be DJing all day at the Dundas on Saturday, March 9th. From 9-ish to 3 when we wrap it all up.
Ampero is a DJ that doesn't get the type of shine that he's supposed to be.
It makes no sense.
True story.
Listen, if you visit the Dungalik Farmers Market on a Saturday, you can hear his Bahamian mix playing every Saturday. There's fresh music listen to. A wonderful compilation of sounds.
And right? He does a mix every Sunday, the Sunday Drive. Really cool. You can also find that on Spotify.
Yeah,
absolutely. Excellent. I love to go to him for jazz and for jazz fusion. Yeah. Okay. International Women's Day is Friday the 8th. Is there a special color?
Wear purple if you can.
All right. Mm-hmm. Is there a theme for this year's International Women's Day? I know there's an overarching theme, which is invest in women, accelerate progress.
We're focusing on care.
Yeah.
Usually at the expo, we really want to focus on community care. moving away from this idea that we have to all be in it by ourselves, making sure that we have space for people to take care of each other, to share resources, to share knowledge. That's why we have all the NGOs come out. That's why we have this real estate agency coming out. We have Nadia Benaby from Relax and Escape who will be offering massage.
Right. Relax and Escape.
Yep.
We got
the energy healing, we have the meditation, we have yoga, lots of fun stuff going on, just so that we can be in community with each other. It's about care.
All right, so let's go through it. At the exhibitor tent, we're going to have Equality Bahamas, massage by Relax and Escape, Bush Medicine with Martha Hannah Smith, Children's Space by Sustainable Me, Art Exhibition by 6260, Letterpress Printing with Ponciana, Paper Press, we're going to have Zumba, Sustainable Gardening, STEM, Writing for Healing, for the Love of Food, Self-Defense, that's what we missed.
Yes, with Sensei Melanie.
Sensei Melanie. I'm going to come out and see if I could perform traditional Bahamian martial arts, dashing. That's when you trip your opponent down and you dash them to the ground and you run away. The best martial arts ever. Sonia, Alicia, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having
us.
The march starts, we gather at 8:45 Eastern Esplanade. The march starts at 9. We're going east on Bay Street to Mackey Street, south on Mackey Street, straight to the Dundas. Join us, line